se ocupa más. Jamás.
Aleluya.
O filho se me llama. Se me te manda a ti la cawe. Epsugaba. A filha se me. Es ocupa más. Jamás. O filho se. Why call them man to look sick, Guyan and Amstange, Gusasoba, Guyan Asima Pagate? Hallelujah. Itembaling and the Pepsugu, Utsumu and the Pepsugu, but to extend the Gukoni daughter. Kamala Elimuchesu Christu was in Nazareth. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Greetings to you, prophet. Greetings to the church at large in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. He's worthy, he's worthy. Ebazalwane, ake simbonge that just to wake up this morning, it is the grace of God. Hallelujah. Let's lift up our hands to our God. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
The chains place to break every chain of poverty, to break every chain of sickness, to break every chain of limitation. He is right here to break every chain.
Sitting full of my sack of where's all of Jehovah?
It's raining,
raining,
oh, it's
To do so, I don't want you to waste my time. Hallelujah. Amen. I've got 30 minutes to be here. 30 minutes. In these 30 minutes, in 30 minutes, we'll close the service. 30 minutes. So, I want to speak to a lot of people. And I gave you an instruction. Don't sit down. I told you that.
Amen.
Don't sit down. Don't sit down. Don't sit down. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Huh?
I'm fine. How are you?
You are not okay.
I'm not okay.
You are not okay. I see you on pews. I see you on pews. I see you on pews. Huh?
Yes, yes,
but
I am.
But these pews, they are like, they are not like for headache.
Mm-hmm. Huh? You are right. You are right, Pastor.
These pews, you have been taking them time and time.
Yes. Huh? Yes.
Now, the Lord spoke to me when I was there. The Lord says, number one, you need healing.
Amen.
Because when I look at you, where are your children?
The one in Zimbabwe, the other one is here.
Huh?
The other one is here.
But I'm not seeing the Father. You are not together with the Father.
I am with the Father. Huh? I am with the Father.
No,
we're not married.
I'm seeing you not together with the Father, because as I'm looking at you spiritually, there is an issue that this man wants to leave you now.
Amen.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
Amen.
Prophecy.
Don't say amen. Don't waste my time. Do you know what I'm talking about?
I know, Pastor. Huh? I know.
Remember that 4 weeks ago you were fighting. Huh? There was like a misunderstanding over somebody. This problem, also your husband has it. Because this is an issue of blood, okay?
Amen.
Your husband is sick. Even you are sick.
Amen.
And the Lord says you need healing right now, because I was seeing you taking like ARVs.
Amen.
ARVs.
Amen.
Is it true?
It's true, your father.
Professor!
Is it true?
It's true, Papa.
Huh?
It's true.
I was seeing you taking ARVs.
It's true, Papa.
This is a curse of the family. Huh? This is a curse of the family. It started in 1968. In 1968, I see everyone in your family suffering with this sickness called HIV. And the Lord says, today it marks the day of your deliverance.
I receive.
Where are your children?
The other one is Zimbabwe. The other one is here.
Huh?
The other one is Zimbabwe.
Even the firstborn is sick.
Go to
Even
Papa.
Your firstborn is sick. Go and check him. Your firstborn is sick. The Lord says, I must deal with a generational curse, because this curse has been in your family for decades.
I receive.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
I know, Papa.
Do you want to be healed?
No. Yes, I want to.
Huh?
I want, Papa. Huh? I want to be healed, Papa.
Stand here. Let me prophesy to other
people. Professor! Get it, Isaac!
You must pray against an accident that wants to take away your life.
Yes, Papa.
Have you heard me?
Yes, Papa.
Huh?
Yes,
you
Papa.
You must be very careful. I see a problem at your workplace whereby people, they'll be jealous of you and putting charm for you.
Okay,
I see three people. I don't know how you Tandi.
Tandi, I used to work with her daddy.
Professor! Prophetic sharpshooter!
You must be very careful. It
yes,
will be
daddy.
On Wednesday. I saw an accident trying to claim your life, but the Lord says, because of your sacrifice,
thank you,
that you have ever shown on the altar, the
thank
Lord
you.
Has remembered you. Go.
Thank you,
Jesus. Come here. Come here. Your husband also is healed of diabetes. Or is this the way you are looking?
Celebrate Jesus.
Yo, come here. He's about to break a curse in your family. Because when I look at your family, I see a curse where people are not getting married.
Yes, Papa.
Are not getting married. Because even you, it's like your mother, she was like just impregnated. And it's like you've never grown up with your father. With
yes.
your father.
True,
and it's like your growing up has been so much tough. So much tough. I even saw you wanted to do like this course of like media.
Yeah.
Then I saw a spirit from your family. I don't know whether you know somebody like this person is from KZN. He's from KZN. His name is like
Professor!
Your life.
Thank you, prophet.
Wait. I see something. There was a man at school. This problem started at your school, where it's like you met another guy, but this guy was like interested in you. And then a chemistry happened. After this chemistry happened, you began to have stomach problem. This stomach problem continues in your life time and time. The Lord says you are free. You, come here. Where's your child? Where's the father of the child? Because it's one child. Look, I told you the spirit of a what? The spirit of a snake entered her. There are most of you, when I look at you, there is an evil spirit that entered you. I prophesy over your life.
I receive.
You are delivered.
I receive it.
In Jesus' name.
I receive.
Where is the father of the child? Because I'm not seeing you together.
He's in Tembe, sir. He's in Tembe, sir.
Why aren't you together?
We separated.
I saw you. You stayed for 1 year, 8 months with him. Then something happened. He went for another woman.
It's true,
but I am seeing the lady by the name of like Linti. Is it true?
It's true, but
as I'm looking at you, because your problem is the same with your mother. Your mother is like, I see three children. You are like number two.
Number two, Baba.
Yeah. Prophecy. Oh. Spiritual substance.
You people.
Now,
where is the firstborn?
They all died. I'm the only survivor.
You are the only survivor. No wonder. There is a spirit that has been claiming. The first one died with HIV. And I'm seeing somebody was killed. I don't know who is this. I see somebody connected to your mother. Somebody like shot with a gun. Go and ask your mother. But this firstborn, the way he died, that's where I'm concerned. Even though it's the same issue with the firstborn. Because when I was looking at you in the spirit, I saw whereby there was a spirit in the form of a monkey claiming the lives of all your siblings. That's the reason you get sick every December. You get sick.
It's true, Papa. It's true.
Professor! The chain breaker.
Now, where is the father of the child? Is it Tembisa?
Yes, Papa.
Now, the Lord says you must continue with your life. You must move on. You will not come back. Right now, he's even making love to Linti.
Our God is here.
Jesus, come. You are free.
Ah, receive it.
Lift up your hands. Say, Father.
Father.
Say, Father.
Father.
I receive my deliverance. In Jesus' name. Do you know June? This month got the June.
Yes, Papa. Yes, Papa.
Who was born in June?
My mother. My mother.
Do you know, Wait. Lift up your hands. Look. Prophecy is like charity work.
Amen.
Prophecy is like charity work. It is very hard to prophesy to wrong people. Now, you, because you have been thinking like this man is going to come back.
Yes, Papa.
Now, I'm telling you, as a prophet, and now there is another woman who is pregnant for him. Write what I've told you. You will come back and confirm what I've said. The Lord says you must move on because the Lord wants to save you. There will be another man who come to you. Okay?
I receive, Papa.
This man, he'll be a man of God. He'll be a man
I
of
receive,
God.
I receive, Papa.
You need to begin to train yourself how to pray.
I receive, Papa.
Because the Lord is going to bring a man of God. And this man of God, he'll be so much influential in the area of deliverance.
I receive.
That's where God will bless you from. Go. In Jesus' name.
Oh.
Yes!
Say, Father.
Father.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I decree and declare. Starting from today. My life. Will never be the same again. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Sit down.
I want to speak to people. Sir, can I speak to you? Sir, stand up. This man, there is a spirit of stroke. with this man?
Came with my daughter.
Huh?
My daughter.
Colette. There's a spirit of stroke on you. Okay? This stroke wanted to kill you. Okay? Not only stroke, but I see this spirit. I see this spirit of madness on your family. Eh?
Yes.
Is it true? Huh?
It's my daughter.
Are you the daughter or what? You have come to help him. Can you help him to answer?
I do not know about like,
the there is a spirit of madness over your family. That's the reason sometimes it's like it goes blank.
Yes, yes, huh? Yes, yes.
Sometimes he forgets you.
Yes.
You forget your name.
Mm-hmm.
Don't say,
yes,
what
Papa.
Is Mumu?
Yes. Yes, Papa.
Mm-hmm. What is Mumu? Prophecy. Look, prophecy is not a joke. When I'm giving you prophecy, you're like, what is that? Answer. Don't be a mumu. Tell me, but don't be a mumu. Tell me, but don't be a mumu.
Don't be a mumu.
Tell me, but don't be a mumu.
Don't be a mumu.
This man, you remember in 2013, I saw him hospitalized. It's like he was in the hospital. It was in August. August.
Yes, Papa.
Huh?
Yes, Papa.
There was something where the doctor said that there's something wrong with his intestine, and it's like his chest.
Yes, Papa.
What did the doctor say?
I know is that like sometime he was diagnosed with cancer and things like that.
Yes.
Yes.
Now, this is the problem that the Lord has showed me, because there's something wrong with his kidney. His kidney right now, they have stopped working. And the Lord says, I must restore his life. Because as I'm looking at him, where is your mother?
She's at home.
Huh?
She's at home.
There was a problem. This man was supposed to...
I receive.
Who is this one on the wheelchair?
He's also at home.
Huh?
He's also at home.
Prophesy!
You! You! Say what? Say one.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
How many wives have you had?
I got one wife. Before.
This is not the woman. You had another one.
Yeah, the first one I divorced.
Eh?
The first one I divorced.
Yes, you had another one. You have forgotten. You had another one.
Yeah, but I divorced.
Now you divorced. Now you are the one who brought the problem for this one. Because you are HIV positive. You are HIV positive. And this wife, she's also HIV positive. Eh?
Yeah, it's true.
Hey!
Nobody likes Professor D.D. Isaac, Super Rich Father Notorious.
You. I see you in a shabin. You know Shabin?
Yeah, I know Shabin.
Uchwalwa. Yes. Bukoko.
It's true, Papa. I was drinking a lot.
That's where I started from. There you met a woman.
Prophesy.
Prophesy.
Yes. There are some of you,
push the whole drum. Today, if you drink beer, I'm coming for you. I am coming for you. Be prepared. Hide whatever you can hide. I will see. Sir, can I ask you a question? Yes?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, you can ask.
Because God wants to give you a gift. If today you are healed now,
yes,
will you maintain your deliverance? Come here. Touch my nose.
Oh!
Jesus! You are free.
I'll receive it.
You are free.
I'll receive it.
Nobody like you, nobody like you, Lord.
Just don't know whether I'm having Boko Haram or ICC in the house.
Thank you, Jesus.
Sir, you are free.
Thank you, Papa.
Is this the firstborn one? You are the firstborn. Eh? Firstborn.
Yes.
Distinction. Go. This done. Go. The Lord is with you. Go. Sit down, sit down, sit down. If I've not told you, sir, can I speak to you? Speak to you. Give me a microphone. Sit down. Let me have a few people.
Yes, Pastor.
Eh?
Yes,
I'm
Prophet.
I'm not a pastor, sir.
Yes, Prophet. Professor, Papa.
I'm not a pastor. Do I look like a pastor, me?
No,
where?
Papa.
Where?
Ah! Yes! Prophet D.D. Isaac!
Me. To you. Do you know Emmanuel? Do you know Emmanuel?
Yeah.
Who is Emmanuel?
My brother.
Huh?
My brother.
Is this preaching? Is this preaching?
No.
Is this preaching?
No. No, Papa.
Huh?
No.
I'm mentioning his brother. Hey, this is preaching, eh? If you had gone to a pastor, God will bless you. Your miracle is on the corner. Let him tell you which corner. Which corner is my miracle so that I can go and take it? Me, I don't believe all this. He said, no, you know, your miracle is on the corner there. You know, I can see it is coming. Pastor, please show me which corner, because there's a lot of corners. So, look, I'm not speaking. This is not prediction.
Yes.
This is not prediction. When I call him, it means I know something about his life.
Amen.
I know something. Now, let me show you something. The Lord has blessed you so much. But when I look at you, you are a struggling man. You are a struggling man. You lose money. You lose money. That is your biggest problem. When I was looking at you, I saw somebody in the spirit by the name of Emmanuel, like your brother. I don't know whether he's an elder brother or what.
The elder brother.
He's your elder brother.
Yes.
Because when I look at Emmanuel, also Emmanuel is the same thing. I don't know somebody like Chima. He's connected to a guy called Chima. And as I look at this Chima, I'm seeing them is like they want to start like a business. But this business, it is a business like a Sholene Ziyahaso.
I receive it!
Because, where is Emmanuel?
Home.
Eh?
It's back home. Where? In Nigeria.
In Nigeria.
Yeah.
Now, Emmanuel is like they want to embark on the business of like cars with Chima. When I looked at in the spirit, I saw Emmanuel now is like having a financial problem. Even you also, financial problem. Because when I was looking at you, I saw like 1, 2, 3, 4 people. When I looked at the 4 people, I saw number 3. Who is
is the number three? Me. Who is the number three?
Me.
Huh?
Me.
Prophesy!
Prophesy!
Yes!
Sharpshooter!
Are you number three?
Yeah.
Eh?
Yes.
Now, do you know why you are having problem?
No.
He answers like a boss.
No, Papa.
Like a CEO of MTN.
No, Papa. Okay.
Do you know that there are people who want to arrest you?
I don't know, Papa.
Eh? There is a lot of attack there. It's a spirit that claims all your family members to be in prison. And this spirit, every time when you come out, when you come out from your homeland, you go to another country, it follows you. That's the reason you were supposed to settle in 2015.
Yes.
But up to now, even your papers are not okay. That's the reason the Lord told me to cancel every spirit aside against your life.
Papa.
Come here. Stand there. Who did you come with?
Come with my friend.
Eh?
I come with my friend.
Your friend?
Yeah.
Eh?
Yes, my friend, Papa.
Eh?
Yes, my friends.
Your friends?
Yeah.
Prophesy!
Prophesy!
You came with your friends?
Yes, Papa.
Where are they? Call them.
The chain breaker.
Your friends.
Yes, Papa.
Thank God for your friends. How are you?
Huh? Fine, sir.
Come here. Today. Do you know Ike?
No, sir.
Huh?
No, sir.
Ask him. He will tell you. Ask him about Ike. Ask him.
Go to Papa. Papa.
Ask him about Ike. There's this place like here. Here.
Okay.
Here.
Huh? Yes,
sir. I see you staying around.
Yes, sir.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
In a complex.
Yes, sir.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
Is it true?
It's true, Papa.
Eh? But that complex, there's a lot of Nigerians.
It's true, Papa.
It's just here in Anidu.
It's true, Papa.
Prophesy! The eyes of God! See the eyes!
Nobody like you, Lord. Nobody
I use this road. This road. I see a place. But this place is like, you know, it's like a garage. It's like a storage.
Yes, Pastor.
It's near a storage. Huh? It's like near a storage.
Yes, Pastor.
Where
yes.
It's like they keep like things. And then next there is like an empty field. An
yes.
empty field.
Yes, Papa.
And then your complex is like next. But before you reach to your complex, there is another one. Shomene Niasuka.
Receive it.
Soproko
Niasuka. Receive it.
Shaliga
Soka. Receive it.
Wait. I want to take where you stay so that I can give you money.
Pa!
I receive, Papa.
You get a man, come here. You have a prophecy for them. Can you hurry up, you get a man? Where, which place do you stay?
I need you.
Huh?
I need you.
Which complex?
But I don't know.
Oh. This man. You don't know where you stay.
Okay.
Wait, stand right there. You, come here. I want to check. Where do you stay?
Honey Rock.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, Pastor.
Next one. To Honey Rock.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Brother Sir. Daddy Isaac. Super Ready Father Notorious. Yeah. Sharpshooter.
Nobody like you, Lord.
Power.
Come on, say, oh. Nobody like you, Lord.
Rock is in front. Huh?
I used to stay in Honey Rock.
Used to stay in Honey Rock.
Yes.
But you shifted to the next one.
Yes.
Power! Did he ice?
This is not guessing.
Yes.
This is
Musoso. Yeah.
Now, you. Come here, sir. They did well to bring you here. Don't worry. Even if I know a lot of things, I'll edit.
Wow.
I know some of you right now. You're like, you, the Lord is going to bless you.
Amen. I receive.
Now, there is a business that the Lord is going to give you. 1, 2, 3. The car business. You must concentrate in it. It's a car business.
I receive.
Now, I see also a shop for you.
I receive.
You must concentrate in opening a shop.
I receive.
Because I saw it's like you are the breadwinner of your family. That's the reason there's a lot of responsibility over your shoulders.
It's true.
Not only that, the Lord says, I must pray for this man. Because I hear a cry of your mother. It's like your mother, she's like sick or what? Where is she?
She's back home.
But she's sick now. Because I see right now your mother crying for you that you must go back to Nigeria. To
true,
Nigeria.
Papa. It's true, Papa.
You must not go back to Nigeria. Your destiny is in South Africa.
See,
the Lord will bless you. The Lord will open up doors for you. Even you. Shout, I receive it.
I receive it.
Shout, I receive.
I receive it.
Shout, I receive.
I receive it.
Do you know Tony?
Go deeper, Papa.
Tony. Do you know Tony?
No, sir.
Huh?
Go deeper.
On a Wednesday, this Wednesday, someone will come at your house number.
Professor.
Wait. This is on Wednesday. Tony coming to your house. There will be a guy that will come. I told somebody. You remember a guy that I told? I said to you, a certain guy will come at your house. And he's going to plant some things. You must be very careful. Let your house be in order. There will be a guy called Tony. He's going to invite police for you. That's the reason I'm telling you, you must be very careful.
Good deal.
I see these guys. They will come at your house. Opposite Honey Rock. And they will find you in a field, in a green field. You'll be seated like the way you sit early in the morning in the field.
Also.
The Lord says you must be very careful. Now, you, the Lord is going to bless you, but be very careful on Wednesday.
I receive.
If this does not happen, come and question me.
I receive. Also.
Come and question. The Lord will bless you.
Amen. Receive. Thank you, Jesus.
Come here. Where's your woman?
She's in Soweto. She's in Soweto.
Keep that woman, eh?
Thank you, sir.
But there's a lot of problem.
It's true, Papa.
Yeah, there's a lot of problem. There's a lot of problem.
It's true, Papa.
But hold on, eh? Don't go for another one. Just hold on a little bit. The Lord is about to bless you. Just that.
Thank you, Jesus.
Sir, where's your passport?
It's at home.
Eh?
It's at home.
It's at home?
Yeah.
Okay. This man, when I look at him, even when I'm praying for him, his heart is doubting. Even when I'm praying for him now, his heart is doubting. Do you know Joseph?
Joseph. No. Yeah, Janet Jeffrey.
Eh?
Yeah.
The one who is in the... Is it Cape Town or what? There's someone in Cape Town.
That's my brother, Destiny.
Eh?
Destiny, my brother.
In Cape Town.
Yeah.
Breakthroughs are coming now.
Yeah, I receive.
Hello.
You shall be protected.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
It looks very easy. Lift up your hands, say, Father.
Father,
I receive. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I want to give you an instruction. But there are too many attacks on your land. And you must be very careful from now to Wednesday. Be very careful. And I take on Tuesday, be in fasting, prayer and fasting. The Lord will touch you.
Thank
God
you.
God bless you.
I will see you. Thank you, Jesus.
I pray for you.
I receive.
That God will touch you.
I receive.
In Jesus' name.
I receive.
You. How are you? Eh? You are free. Go. Your papers have been released.
I came with my husband's daughters. So she's there. She can't find a job, but she pays matric. Please. Eh?
Go. You?
How are you, Prophet?
Hey, I'm okay. Yeah, and I'm fat. Yes, how are you also?
I'm not well, Prophet.
Eh?
I'm not well.
What's the problem?
I'm trying to go and get papers and...
Come here. Walk. Stand here. Look at me. Why are you shy? You know, there's some people, they are just shy to look at me. Why? Eh? I know every time when I look at you, my eyes are not normal eyes. They're not normal eyes. Where is your husband?
In Zimbabwe.
Eh?
In Zimbabwe.
So you are looking for what?
No, we are separated.
You are separated?
Yes.
So you are looking for papers?
No, I'm trying to move on and I want to.
You want to move on?
Yes.
Why do you want to move on?
Because he wants a divorce, so.
Do you have any children with him?
Yes.
How many?
One.
Let me give you an advice. If you're a woman, let me give you an advice. Once you are married, don't think you are the best. I want to tell you this because count yourself as favored.
Wow.
You have been favored by God. Not that you are the best. When you recognize that the reason why you're in marriage is because of the favor of God, you will regard yourself the least and God will make you the best to your husband.
Pow!
The problem is not marriage. The problem is that you are the best. That's the problem. The problem is not what? Marriage. The problem, you are the what? You are the best. You are the best to yourself. That's the biggest problem. You are the best to yourself. And that's the reason when your husband looks at you, there is nothing to appreciate because your everything is okay. Count yourself as least and put God first in your marriage. You will see. The man will begin to appreciate you.
But when you say, hey, me, I am very beautiful, even if when you leave me, another one will come. When? That's a problem with a lot of women and a lot of men. No, you know, even if when you leave me, even if when you leave me, I will marry another woman. You will marry another woman? Do you know how expensive marriage is nowadays? I can promise you, whenever you divorce, your life is never the same. I promise you this. Look at most people who divorced. If they used to do well, they become financially crippled. Divorce is not just a physical thing. Divorce is a spiritual thing. It's a spiritual thing. I see people, they wake up like, you know, I want to divorce my... Do you know what you're talking about? You? I want to divorce my husband. I want to divorce him. Do you know what divorce does? It's not just a physical thing. When you leave somebody, when you separate with somebody, there is also an element spiritually that leaves you. That's the reason you must count yourself as the least. Don't say, no, me, I'm beautiful. Even if when you leave me, another man will come and marry me. My sister, you will wait for the rest of your life with your beauty, with your powder. You want another man to come and take your problem? To come and take your problem. Sort out your problem. What I mean is very simple. I'm so much grace in marriage. When I look at a lot of people, a lot of women, I'm able to know whether this one, she's a problem, or is a man who is a problem. Count yourself as least. Don't come on the level where you say, even if my husband leaves me, it's okay. She has already found a source of what? Encouragement. Any woman who says, even when you leave me, it's okay. Know that there is a snake somewhere gossiping like Eve. Be careful. No matter how much you have problem in your marriage, there is a way how to sort it out. Divorce is final. It's not final. Eh? Divorce is not final. Okay, what happens if you have divorced with somebody? You left him very poor. You divorced him. And then you one day, you enter a shopping mall. You find him driving a Maserati. What happens to your heart? You'll be like, damn. And then he's holding another woman. You'll be like, damn. Look at you. Look at you. Holy Ghost fire. Die by fire. Die by fire. Your heart, you know it is what? It is paining. You saw you could not see beyond. Now another woman comes to appreciate something that was not supposed to be appreciated. Let me tell you, there is no ugly woman on the face of the earth. There is no ugly man. I promise you. No ugly man. You know, my wife, when she was accepting me, she did not know that I'm very handsome like this. I'm telling you, she did not know. But when I began to go through a process of metamorphosis, everything changed. And when I'm coming out of my bedroom, she'll be like, is this the man I married? Or what? Because now we are decorated. Let me tell you, if you're a married woman, a married man, the duty of a man is to bring out the beauty. If you love yellow bone, go buy your wife Carolite.
power.
Oh, you are laughing.
Power. Yeah.
Fond of every time when a woman passes, you are with your wife because your wife, she's black. She's black. Every time the yellow board passes, they'll be like, ooh la la. So if you love yellow board, please, I advise you as a man, go and apply, go buy calorite for your wife. Tell her that you must apply until you become yellow board. Long hair, go and tell him. Go ask him, what do you love? He said, no, I love long hair. Go buy even fake. Brazilian, put it. That's wisdom. You are in marriage, you are still looking like a mama mufo. Like a chief herbalist. Lift up your hands and say, Father, help me.
Father, help me.
A certain lady, she's crying. Eh? I'm telling you. Lift up your hands and say, Father, help me.
Father, help me.
Know what your husband loves. The reason you see my wife beautiful is because behind there is a high level of investment. You're a stingy man. You leave your wife to stay with Blazirana for 7 months. It's like a pregnancy. For both manicure and pedicure, and then also you take her for facial.
Yes.
They remove all those mountain Kilimanjaros. Are you listening? Huh? here and then just go somewhere. When you come, you will forget your wife. When appearance changes of your wife every day, love grows. Are you listening? Women have different appearances. Today look like a rose flower. The other day look like a pumpkin with nice colors. Not just one color, black. Every day, black. Every day, black. Every day. Lift up your hands. Say, Father.
Father.
Help me.
Help me.
Say, Father.
Father.
Help me.
Help me.
Every day, black. That dread, he found you with it, with it. Are you a reggae star? Be creative. Be creative. I thank God. Look, I thank God that I matured at a very tender age. I matured at the age of 13. That's the reason I'm able to handle big issues. So be prophetic. Husband, sow into the life of your wife. Eh? So give her money. Give her money. Give her money. I was watching a certain movie yesterday. This man was a stingy man. He had about 7 billion. Seven billion. It was 7 million rands, naira. He put it in the bank. And then the man got sick. What he did, he took those ukwa back and tied it on his leg. They took him to the doctor. The man said, "No, I'm just okay. I don't want my money to be eaten." Until the man died. The man died. There are many rich men, if you look at their wives. You even say, "Sir, are you a Satanist or what?" Because it's pure Satanism if your wife, she's not looking well. Lift up your hands. Say, "My marriage will never be like that. In the name of Jesus." So, now, the problem is not your husband. The problem is something that must be solved. Have you heard?
Yes, huh? Papa. Yes, Papa.
Now, what do you think is a problem? I'm asking you, what do you think is a problem in your marriage?
I think it had so many people involved, especially the family.
How many people?
From his family and my family, our parents.
Your parents? What is the problem? What is the problem?
The family did not like me.
The family did not like you.
And my family also. Like them. My family also did not like them, so we got married because we loved each other, but not because the family were against it.
They are against it.
Yes.
Now let me show you something. You woman. This is a problem with a lot of women. Whenever you want to settle, don't think it's easy. You say that you loved that man, isn't it? And the family, they were against, isn't it?
Yes.
And
yes.
Your mother, she was against, and your father, isn't it?
Yes.
But you loved him.
Yes.
Where there is love, no matter how much the persecution, the misunderstanding, you will remain in that marriage. But here, what I see is the influence from your mother. Is it true?
No, he's the one who left me.
He did what?
He left me.
Yeah, but he cannot just leave this man. Can't. There must be an influence. There must be an influence somewhere. Because you say that in the beginning he loved you. The love cannot just finish just like that. It can't. There's something. So there is an influence from your mother's side. Because already the mother and father, they don't like him. So they will open up to the child. They say, we don't like this man. Now, let me tell you something prophetically. Your husband loves you. But the influence that you were fed began to cause you to behave so strange in your house. And that's what made this man to leave. And it is not in the will of God that you may divorce.
True, Papa.
It's not. This woman, she's not supposed to divorce. But her character towards this man. You know, even your father and mother, they don't like your husband. Be a hope to your husband.
Help me, Papa.
And this is what I'm doing now. So now, what you must do, because you are a woman of ego, too much ego. Don't say sorry. You don't say sorry. You don't say sorry. This man is not in the will of God that you may divorce with this man. You must go back to him. So I need now to pray a certain prayer to cause that other woman to disappear so that the eyes of this man might concentrate on this woman.
Yes, Papa.
So, you need to humble yourself. Even this man, when he was going, you did not even consider. You say, let him go. Let him go. Let him go. That's not marriage. That is being heartless. A man that you have been with, the moment he says, I am leaving you, something must trigger in your mind. You can't just say, go. You can't. So, there is a big problem here. When you listen to your mother and the father, I'm telling you, you will forever be single. Now your house is destroyed. It's destroyed now.
Help me, Papa.
This young man is a very good young man. Very good young, very loving. Very loving young man. Supportive. But imagine, another woman is not in the hands of another woman. Yet, prophetically, it is not in the... This woman, she is not supposed to divorce. Yet, the man is with another woman. So, what must we do? Some of your husbands are with another woman. So, we must offer a prayer. A prayer of divorce. Now, you must humble yourself. Eh? Yeah, you must humble yourself. You know too much. You know too much. Humble yourself, number one. I will give you direction. And I'll be able to call this man. Okay?
Okay,
in my
Papa.
Own capacity, God will give me the grace to restore your house.
Thank you, Papa. Thank you, Papa.
But humble yourself now. Eh? Humble yourself. You're a very good woman, but there's a spirit from your family that does not want you to stay in marriage.
Yes, Papa.
So we'll handle it. I'll call your husband, and I've given you 3 months. Your house will be restored.
Thank you, Papa. Thank you.
A certain man was involved in a car accident, and he called the wife. He said, my wife, I'm involved in a car accident. The woman asked him a question, who are you with? Huh? My wife, I've been involved in a car accident. The woman, she responded, who are you with? Call me on WhatsApp. I want to see. The man said, I was with a lady, the one I was taking to the for work. The woman responded, what is her name? Well, the man is dying. What is her name?
He mentioned the name. The following question: how did you know each other? She did not show any concern. She did not. When the man just recovered, he went direct to the court. He said, there is no need of pastor here. Right away, divorce. Because if such kind of, she can kill, I can be dying while she's laughing. So your husband's a very good man. So I pray that God will restore your house and humble yourself now. Okay?
Okay,
send him
Papa.
A message. Send him a message. Tell him I'm sorry. Eh?
Okay,
and
Papa.
Then, plus God's intervention, your house will be restored. God bless you. Clap hands for Jesus. You, what's your problem?
I came with my brother's wife.
Eh?
And I'm also not well, Papa.
Eh?
I'm also not well.
Okay. Go, it is done. You? What's the problem?
My father is diabetic and my mother is suffering from arthritis.
Go, it is done. Lift up your hands. Say, Father.
Father.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Deliver me.
Deliver me.
Now.
Now.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
There is a couple here. You fought this week a lot. You fought a lot this week. Come in. You fought a lot. A lot. Come here. Come here. You fought a lot. I want to restore your house. You fought a lot. You fought a lot. You fought a lot. You fought a lot. Come here. There is a couple. You fought a lot this week. Come here. Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Go in front. Go in front. Stand there. Stand there. Stand there. Today we are in a court. We're in a court. We're resolving issues. Give us the microphone. Yes, what is the problem? Let's hear. What's the problem?
We are fighting a lot, Daddy. We are fighting a lot.
Why are you fighting?
It's the issue that at the moment he's not working. I'm the only one working. So
he's not working?
At the moment, yes.
Yeah, the only one who is working, yes.
Yes. And so I feel a lot of pressure. I feel a lot of pressure over me.
Okay. So, so is it the issue of him not working or you feeling a burden because you are the one who is providing for the family?
Yes.
You are feeling a burden?
A burden, yes.
Because you are providing for the family. Okay,
yes.
Let's hear from the big man. Yes, big man.
Yes, Didi.
Pour out, we're in a court of law.
Daddy, from my side, the issue is, okay, I'm not working, she's the one providing.
Sir, look at me, be free.
The
be
issue
free.
Is drinking, Papa.
Eh? Drinking?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
We were both drinking. We used to both drink.
You both drink?
Both,
so
yes.
You were exchanging?
Then I quit drinking. She is still
She took over
drinking.
From you.
No, now, when she's drunk, that pressure that she feels like, oh, I'm the one who's providing and started there when she's drunk. Yes.
Okay. So that is the problem.
Yes.
Problem is drinking.
Drinking.
Drinking. Okay. So you are the one who introduced her.
No, Daddy.
Who introduced her?
I think we both, when we met, we were both drinking.
Okay. This is good. Clap hands for Jesus. When you met, both you met while you were drinking.
Yes.
It's good.
to God is good. Do you know? God says, he that finds a wife, finds what? Whether she drinks, to God is what? Whether she beats you, to God is a what? Whether she sits on you, to God is a what? To God is a what? A good thing. Now, your foundation here is a problem. Number one, your foundation is a problem. Number two, you are annoyed. Okay, number two is that you are a weak man. Let me put it like this. You are a weak man. What do I mean? You are weak in decision. Because if you are a father of a house and your wife, she's going astray, there must be that form of authority to tell her that no, this is not good. But because you are already in the same thing, you don't have the power inside you to tell her that what she's doing, it is bad, because also you do it. Drinking. That's the reason there is a big issue here. You, number one, as a husband, when you see your wife drinking, there must be that voice. Imagine your wife, she takes 7 and you take 7. You are competitors. Because she takes 8, even you take 8. So it is like in your house, there's a lot of competition. Competition with drinking beer. Number three. You, woman, you have a big problem.
Yes, Daddy.
Can I tell you a problem?
Yes, Daddy.
Your problem is the way you were taught. This is a problem of a lot of women. When it is a man, it is our money. Yes. When it's a man who is working, it is our money. If it is a lady who is working, it is my money. That's where there is a big problem. Marriage, it is not a combination of one person. It is two coming together and making up a house. So there is dry seasons in marriage and tough moments. It is just a matter of you to understand your husband, his present condition. Because if you don't understand his present condition, you'll be thinking you are his husband. Your providing in the house does not mean this man cannot provide.
Yes, Daddy.
I'm speaking for men. Men are now clapping hands. A woman providing does not mean a man cannot provide. Remember, we're talking about a dry season here. A man is going through some certain thing. And a good woman, a wise woman, beauteth with what? With understanding. You need to have a form of understand the present condition. It does not mean that this man will be in this condition for the rest of your lives. So you provide. As you are providing, you are helping him, you are helping yourself, you are helping the children, and you are building your house.
Amen.
It becomes a problem when a woman says, now, since I'm providing everything, and most women, they become like men. That's the reason you end up seeing a man saying that, I feel not comfortable. I feel like my wife, she's underrating me, or she's looking down on me. me because I cannot provide. Never make your husband feel like that. Even when you are providing as a woman. Provide and keep quiet. Provide and keep quiet. You women do like this. Shh. Do like this. Provide and what? Provide with the left hand and your mouth must keep quiet. Your surrounding must not know that now your husband is not working. You are now the one who is providing even the pampers of the baby, even the renters of the house. You are the one who is paying for them. But also you as a husband, you must not become a liability. Or a burden. You know, there are men who are babies. You as a man, you must feel bad. You must feel bad. In fact, her providing of the family must force you, must provoke you to go and look for something to do.
Yes, daddy.
Amen.
Because personally, I can't allow my wife to do that. I can't. Because when she provides, it puts pressure inside my heart. Because it's my responsibility to provide. So it's like my wife, she has taken over. So when she, look, to take over the responsibility is not bad where there is understanding. But when I see her, she begins, she has taken over everything. That one, I become uncomfortable. There are men, they only sit at home. They will sit at home. From morning to evening, they are watching Isidingo and Telemundo. Watching Isidingo and Telemundo. And after watching, the wife will come, they begin to ask the wife food. Where is my food? You are a social disaster. And on top of that, you begin to fight with your wife. The one who is feeding you. You must first appreciate God that you have found a woman who has got a sense to provide. So, that must give you a lot of pressure inside you not to sit on one place. And now begin to push. Something will happen.
I do, Papa. I push.
You push.
I push.
After you push, what happened?
I'm still waiting for my...
You are still waiting?
Yes.
Now you push alone. That's your problem. You push alone. Now you must push together. Yeah, look. She's pushing and he's pushing. So these are two different parties. Two different what? Parties. We have got DD party. And we have got also GC party in one house. So it doesn't need to work like this. You must hold hands and plan together. Plan together. Because the way I'm looking at you, this one, she plans alone.
That's true. You plan alone.
So this is not marriage. It's not marriage. Marriage. Whatever a woman, whether you are working, you must be able to respect your husband's decision. I know it is your money, but when you come home, even for the sake of transparency, show him even your bank statement. But look at the kind of a husband you are showing a bank statement. There are some others, they are thieves. So look at him. He's an open man. There's no need even for you to be afraid. He's your husband. You have stayed with him. So you must trust him and open up towards him.
Yes.
Very soon, there'll be a miracle.
I receive. We receive, Daddy. We receive.
Now, you number one.
Yes, Daddy.
Because of the current situation of your husband, I'll pray for him. God is going to give him a miracle. But
thank you.
Don't be like this.
because you are providing. No. Humble yourself. Do everything at home.
Yes, Daddy.
Okay?
Yes, Daddy.
Even sometimes when you are tired, also try to understand her. Maybe sometimes she's very tired. She's very tired. Try to understand her. It is part of marriage. Marriage, there's a need of tolerance. You need to tolerate. You need to have patience. Eh? You need to have what? Patience. You need to pray for your partner. That is marriage. So, your union is a divine union. It's a divine arrangement.
Thank you, Daddy.
But your foundation is destroyed. We need to go back to your foundation. You, if you must raise a responsible house, you must stop drinking beer. Even you must stop drinking beer.
Deliver.
And also look on God for the sake of your children, for the sake of your house. So you have a big problem, she has a big problem. So then who has a problem here? No one. It's the devil between them. The devil between them is the one who has problem. There is something here.
Deliver us, dead.
So they are fighting because of an influence. Now, look at each other. Okay. Okay, now, I want to show you this. Do you see this? Fight. 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 He can't fight because he can't see the wife. Eh? Which means every time you see a couple fighting, there is unseen force causing the conflict. So this one, she's a good woman, he's a good man. There is a devil between them. The devil does not want you to stay in marriage. You must know that. So now, how has she been treating you?
She's been treating me very, very good, Papa.
Very good, eh?
Very good. The problem comes when she's drunk. And that is
when
where
she's
she
drunk?
Explodes. Yes. That is where she's
when she's hyper.
Yes, Daddy.
She's in cloud 7. Okay, how does it treat you? How does it treat you? Eh?
Very good. Eh? Very good, Daddy.
Very good, eh?
Yes.
So he's a good man.
Yes.
So it is just the issue of understanding his present situation. Kneel down. Kneel down as a wife. Look at her. Look at her. Look at her. Come here. Ask for apology. That's the best. A woman who cannot ask apology, she's about to be kicked out of her own house.
I'm very, very sorry, baby.
Tell him the good words. Tell him how much you love him.
Please forgive me. You know I love you a lot. And I know God is going to change our situation. And I believe in you so much. And I believe in God. And I'm so sorry.
Yeah. What are you waiting for? The moment you say sorry, even when God wanted to do something to you, right away the anger of God is quenched. Sir, what do you say? She's your wife. She's your wife. You can't do anything to her. She's born of your God, flesh. You're already married to her.
My love. I forgive you, and I'm sorry as well. You've been doing so much to me, to our family, and as we pray every day, I know that the face of God is watching us. The devil is a liar. He will never do anything. Thank you, Jesus.
Stand up, lady. Stand up, stand up, stand up, stand up. Stand up. Sir, hug your wife, eh? She's your wife. She's not your colleague. Don't hug her like you are holding a paw. Hug her very well. Clap hands for Jesus. There are some certain men, they hug their wives. Are you a paw? Now, come here, come here. Put your two hands for Jesus. Come, 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 come. Hold hands, hold hands. Kneel down here. Kneel down, kneel down, kneel down, kneel down. Father, with a blessing upon my life, I bless this couple. Give him a job in the name of Jesus. What do you do? do?
I'm with my brother. We're selling properties.
Property?
Yes.
I have given 21 days from now. All your doors are open. In the name of Jesus. Stand up. Your marriage needs to be blessed. No, there's no blessing on you. Okay?
Yes.
There's no blessing. You need to go through marriage counseling. Okay? Marriage counseling. You need to be shown how to be a wife, and you need to be shown how to be a husband. There are things not to do in the marriage. There are things not to do in the marriage. So until you are taught, you can't know them. So I pray for you, and I'll have time with you. I'll have time with you. Teach you, and all your doors will be opened. Congratulations. God bless you. Take her. Hold her very well. Yeah, put your two hands for Jesus. I know some of you are not clapping hands. You see, you left your husband thinking that is a problem. It's not a problem. If you had brought your husband here, you see, he would have been changed. But you say, oh, you get out. I'm going to find the Karabo. Yes, let's hear. Yes, let's hear. What's the problem?
We were separated for like a year and 3 months. So now we're trying to work things, but we are fighting a lot.
You are separated?
Yes.
For 1 year?
3 months.
3 months?
Yeah.
What was the problem of the separation? What led to the separation? Can you speak up, woman? Speak up. Yeah, speak up. Speak up, and I want you to be open because we want to sort it out now. Okay?
Okay, it was because of another woman.
Another woman?
Yes.
How did you know?
I found out by myself.
You found out. How did you find out?
I went to a place where I met him with a woman. And the woman herself, she's the one who told me that she's there with him.
Can I ask you, where did you go?
Okay, I went to a club.
She went to the club to investigate.
No, I didn't go to investigate. I went there with my sister and my auntie. That's when I found his cousin with the woman. And then I went to talk to him, like to find out what was he doing there with another woman, because he's also married.
Okay, what was he doing? Also, you, what were you doing there?
Okay.
I'm asking. Okay. All of you are in one boat. And then you begin to condemn each other. It's your problem. I'm asking a question. What did you go to do there?
Okay. I don't normally go to clubs. That day I went to take one of my aunties that came from Congo. She said she wanted to go. So me and my sister, we escorted her. Because she didn't know the place and she didn't know English. So that's when I met him with that woman there.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So how was your reaction?
No, okay. When I went to his cousin, I was asking him, who is this? He obviously knew that the woman was there with him, so he couldn't tell me. So I asked the woman, I'm like, this is my husband. Who are you? She's like, no, I'm not here with him. I'm here with Ricky. She mentioned his name. That's how I knew that he was.
You just
there.
Said she's.
I'm here with Ricky, his cousin.
Did
yes.
Did she tell you? Did she tell you that she's a girlfriend?
If I remember, yes.
She did.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, sir. Let's hear. Is it Ricky? His name is Ricky.
Yes, it's.
Ricky, Mr. Ricky.
Yes. The time that she found me in the club, we were separated already for like almost three months. We're not together. we used to separate for 6 months, 3 months, and go back together.
We used to go for vacation.
Yeah, we used to have a lot of problems. We can fight for a spoon for nothing.
A spoon?
Yeah, it was bad.
For Jesus. A spoon, eh? Okay. Continue.
So that day I met that girl there. We separated. We wanted even to make the divorce. And I met her there. And we tried to work things out after that. But it didn't work out. So I continued with that other girl for over 1 year and 3 months. So now
while you were with her?
No, we separated again.
So you separated and then you entered in another relationship?
Yes.
Okay.
But
give her a microphone. She's having something. Pour out your hand, yes.
No, he continued even when I found him with her. He continued with her. Even when we got back together, he was with her. I didn't know until one day I found out. He told me, no, I'm going to end things, blah, blah, blah. But it
what
seems
is blah,
like
blah,
he never...
Blah.
He told me he was going to end the relationship, but I guess it didn't because now they were together almost for 2 years and we were separated for a year and 3 months.
Okay. Yes, yeah. Back to you.
Yeah. When we got back together with her, things were not fine. So it was just like a formality to be with her. It was not like we were together. We were fighting for no reason. Life was impossible.
So you got back together. Is it in the house?
In the house, yes. But
you were staying together.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
And then until I got fed up, I told her as well that it's not gonna work. We need to separate. Then we did the separation. Yeah, for
can
1 year.
Can I ask you a question?
Yes.
As a man.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
What makes you to be hate every time you see this woman? What hates you? What provokes you whenever you see this woman? Or what kind of things that makes her to be a bad woman?
She can be rude, like very rude sometimes.
How?
She's the way that she can speak to you and when you fight, the way that she can push you, it's very, not physically, but with word and all
with
that.
She's,
yeah, so it's bad. That's what, every time, sometimes I'll be fine, and if I think of what she said to me,
it's like an injection.
Yeah.
okay. So she's so rude.
Yeah, she's a good woman. She's got good side. But
so there's a good side. There's a good side.
Yeah.
And there's a bad side.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Now, you back to you. What things don't you love to see in him?
Okay. Like before, he used to drink a lot.
Uh-huh.
Used to drink a
lot.
I
told you that today there's what? There's drinking problem. Huh?
Yeah. He used to drink a lot. He would go out because we have 2 kids. He would go out, let's say maybe he goes to work, and from work he would go out and come back
the following day. He went for the overnight. He went for night shift. Don't cry. Be strong. Just speak it out. Allow it. We are in a court. Here you are allowed to cry. Cry. We need to sort it out. We need to sort out the problem. Yes, woman, continue.
So he used to do things like that. So at the end of the day, that's what hurt me also. I became like rude to him because when he goes out, I'll have like at that time, my son, my firstborn, was like 1 year, 3 months, and the other one was very small. So it could go out like that. And then when you call him, even in the middle of the night, maybe he won't even pick up your call. And when he comes back in the morning, he will be acting as if whatever he did, there's nothing wrong with that. So that's what used to hurt me so much. I just became rude towards him. Otherwise,
so you
never
became rude because of the character he was given to you.
Yes. And okay. Then the reason why I even left, because I'm the one.
Are you the one who left him?
Yes. I'm the one.
Put the two hands for Jesus. She's the one what? Who left? Not the man. Capture that point. Uh-huh.
The reason why I left, because it became so bad to the point that he could go out when he comes back, because we used to stay with his mom and his sister. He would come back and then we'll be sitting, and then he would rather go ask for food from his mother than me. And then
you ask food from his mother?
Yes.
Than you?
Yes. Okay. And then we would sleep like on separate beds.
Hey!
I would sometimes.
That's a dangerous, is criminal. It's like you're a criminal. I'm telling you. Let me tell you. Do you know what destroys? Do you know what destroys the house? Eh? So you're sleeping in separate bed.
Yes, and sometimes maybe I will say, okay, you know what, I do love this man. I want this marriage to work out. Maybe I will pray or do a fasting and something. I'll ask him, let's fast together. He will refuse. And then I'll just go maybe kneel down in front of him, ask him to forgive me for something.
Has she ever knelt down before you?
Once or twice, yeah.
Huh?
Once or twice.
Once or twice.
Yeah.
So you remember?
Yeah, I remember. That time I was not praying that much.
That time you were not praying.
Yeah, I was drinking and clubbing and all that. So I changed all those.
Have you ever knelt down?
Me, no. I never do that.
You don't do that.
No, it's not that I don't do
clap
that.
Clap
hands. He
doesn't do that. Okay, back to you, woman. I want to hear. So, what hurts you is that he began asking food from the mother, and you were sleeping on different beds. Uh-huh.
Yeah, and then sometimes he would use words like, you know what, I don't want you. I want a divorce. You must go back to your parents' house. Things like that. And then we never used to talk at all. He could come back from work. He would rather go tell his mother what happened at work than me. And then when he goes to work, his mother, she will be the one telling me, do you know what happened at Ricky's work? Things like that. So all that just became too much on me.
Clap hands for Jesus. Can I speak? Huh? Can I speak?
Yes.
It's a court, eh? Back to the man, to the husband.
Yes.
Sir, number one, I want to congratulate you. You're a strong man. Yeah. There are few men that can come in front of the prophet, and the prophet is solving their issues. There are few men. This man, there is room for his marriage to be restored.
Amen.
There are few. Now, the first thing that I look at this issue, yes, you were married, but you have not left your father's house.
No, we had our house, and then we
You're
separated.
You're not getting what I'm saying. I speak in a parable. They are married, but they have not left him. He has not left his father's house. You had a house together. But I'm talking about where you are coming from. The Bible says a man shall live. Huh? Shall live, which means you will leave your parent, your father, you will leave your mother, and you will come and build your house with this one. So now you were having a house, but you did not leave from where you were coming from. So you are close to your mother. I'm not saying that being close to your mother, it is a problem, but that is bringing problem in your house.
Yes.
You must be close to your mother, but more close to your wife. You're not getting this. You must be close to your mother, but more close to your partner. So you are married to her, but you have not left your mother. You have not left your relatives. And that is what is destroying your house. What is destroying your house? It is your family. You have brought the third part in the house. Any marriage that has got the third part in the house, that marriage is about to be destroyed. So you have allowed. Look, that is not the house of your brothers. That is not the house of your mother. Your mother, she has a house. We are not saying that your mother, she must not be coming there. She must not have a voice in your marriage. But when you see that the third part is becoming a problem in your house, take it very serious. So what I see is that you are married. You are a very good man, but you are so much connected. You are so much connected, and that bond has not been broken. It has not been broken. Any man whose bond has not been broken, he will still go back. He's married, but when there's a problem, he can never speak to the wife. He will go back to the mother and sit with the mother, explain, look, you are not married to your mother. Your mother should not give you children. Your mother, she brought you out so that you can have a separate house, you as the president of that house. Rule it according to God's principles. So, you are married, but that process of breaking, it has not yet happened. That's the reason it is very hard for your wife to open up to you, because she knows you are so close to your mother. You open up. You prefer talking to your mother some things of your house. It is very wrong as a couple. Look, it is how you must be close to your mother. It is her who must be close to your mother, and it is you who must be close to her mother. That is marriage. So, number one, you are going to work on the bond. You are going to work. You work on it, work on it. Number two. Double dealers. Double dealer. Let me tell you, do you have a tattoo behind?
No, I don't have any tattoo.
You don't have a tattoo? Okay. When you are born, do you have like a mech? Like a mech? A black mech?
Not really.
Something behind you. Now, you must ask your mother very well. Okay? Where is your father?
He's dead.
He's dead.
Yeah.
Now, let me show you something. The second problem that I want to mention is not that this man does not love you, but this man is between two decisions. There's one line, his legs are appearing in two places. So he's walking like this. So this side he eats small, the other side small. He continues with the journey. You have a problem with decision. A bigger one. A bigger problem when it comes to decision making. And that is what is costing your marriage, because you can't make a decision. And you are a man that does not say sorry. You don't say sorry. That is your biggest problem. You don't say sorry, you are Mr. Right. There are men who are Mr. Right. You can't make a decision, you can't say sorry.
Yes.
Even when she found you, look. You had separated for 3 months.
3 months, 6 months, 4 months, six months.
So how many times have you separated?
More than five.
Huh? How many times?
More than five.
More than five, you?
Yeah.
Eh?
Three times.
Which one should I believe?
Six. 6 months, 4 months, and 1 year, 3 months.
And 1 year, 3 months.
Yeah.
Huh?
And 1 week.
And 1 week.
And, yeah.
And one. So you separated for 1 week.
It was really bad. We started
that
fighting.
That one for 1 week.
We started fighting when we got married. 1 week, 1 month after we got married, we started fighting. And she was blaming me that I'm seeing other girls when I was not doing
so
that.
So she was blaming you from
I was
the
not
beginning
doing
of
that.
Your marriage.
Every time I go out to drink, I will go drink. I'm not going to go to other women. But
is
she's
going
to blame me.
We started fighting when it was 2 weeks after the wedding.
So you are telling him that he has got other shakara?
No, the first time we fought, it was not about that. He was drunk. And his friend was around, and it was late. He wanted to go out. So he asked me for the keys for the car. I refused to give him, so he wanted to beat me in front of his friend.
Hey.
Yeah.
Did he bless you?
No, I didn't. I never beat
her. Did he bless
anyone.
You? Did he bless you?
I never do that to her. Never.
He did not do that?
I never do that anyway.
Now, number one is that you can't make decision. Number two is that you are a man who knows everything. You can't say sorry. Number three, the base and the foundation of your marriage has a lot of problems.
Yes.
Has a lot of problems.
Yes.
Now, let's just put it like you separated six times. The question that is coming in my mind, is this a wrong marriage? Huh? Hey, I'm asking you, is this a wrong marriage? Huh? Is this a wrong marriage? Do you think that this woman, she's a wrong woman, you married the wrong woman?
She's very good, but sometimes she's another person.
Let's try to remove bad.
Bad. She's a good woman.
But she's a good woman.
Yeah.
What about the rest?
If she works on it, it's going to be fine.
If she works on it.
Yeah.
You woman, back to you. You're a very good woman. But your mouth, she can talk. This woman, she can talk.
Deliver me, prophet.
I'll deliver you after this. This woman, she can talk. The problem that you have is that you can't control your mouth. And you don't look at the words that you speak to your husband. You just speak anything. You just speak anything. Number two, you are like a police officer.
That one I know.
You know it. You are like a police officer in the house. You are not romantic at all. You know, there are some certain women. Be at least, even if you are annoyed, let your face be romantic. What is happening? You must be, look, if you hard. You are becoming a man. Women are soft in nature, even in their voices. When you see a woman, she's very hard. It's a character of a man. So, there must be this soft nature in you. You're from where?
From, I'm originally from Congo, but I was born in Zambia.
You?
I mix Congo and French.
Hey, no wonder. Foundation here. You, when I look at you, is exactly like your mother. Your mother, she's straight like this. Straightforward. And you and your mother is exactly. That's a reason you must never take some certain culture, some certain systems from your mother and bring them in your house. It won't put to work. So you must at least try to be soft. Soften up a little bit. You are a woman, you know? You are a woman. Imagine if I greet a woman like this and the hand sounds like a pan brick. I'll ask myself, is this a man or a woman? Because there must be what? A soft what? Soft nature. Even in our voice, there must be that soft nature. Not a woman, but, hey, you, who are you? So you must be very soft. Number three. Are you still drinking or you stopped?
I'm no longer drinking.
You?
Me, I don't drink at all.
You?
It's now 4 months that I don't drink.
4 months. Now, let me tell you something. Number three problem that you have is, can I mention this? You must ask him after this, you must ask him what he wants to see in you. He will write to you. You just ask him what he loves to see in you. Just ask him now.
What do you love to see in me?
Look at each other.
Respect. Eh? Respect.
Uh-huh.
Understanding.
Uh-huh.
Just those two.
For a woman, it's three things. The problem of women is three. Number one, he does not respect me. He does not understand me. He does not give me time. Yeah. Those are the three problems of women. That is your problem. You are so much into friends.
Yeah, I dropped that. I don't have a friend anymore.
Okay.
Used to.
This one must be your friend. Okay? She must be your friend. You must cut away all these friends. And starting from today, see her as your best friend. The other thing that I want to tell you, that is a big problem. You people, the devil has entered your bedroom life. The devil has entered your bedroom. No matter how much you fight with your husband, never put him on fasting. Seven days fasting. They will see. You go on dry.
Deliver us, then.
Dry fasting. Never put any man on dry fasting. Eh, you are laughing, eh? There are some certain women like, you will see. You will see. You will come. And when they are going to sleep, a woman, she will put on a military combat. Military combat and gum and boots. Boots. Imagine. With you. The Bible says, do not deprive of one another. That's where the devil enters a lot of people. leave the bed.
Okay.
You did not know. Never leave the bed. Because the moment you leave the bed and you begin to sleep down, you are inviting a spiritual wife, you are inviting a spiritual husband. That's how a lot of spiritual husband and spiritual wife entered people. So you must never leave your bed. Your bed. Your bed is an altar. That's the reason if you're a married man, your bed is an altar. Every time you have a problem, whenever you cry to God, God is able to answer you based on the altar. That's the reason your bedroom life must be very secret. It must be kept very secret. Once the devil enters in that area, you are gone. You are gone. You will think like she's bad. You have invited spirits. Now you have been torturing her emotionally. Torturing her emotionally. You. So even you could also sleep down?
No. He used to leave the bedroom.
He used to leave.
He would go sleep in the lounge. Sometimes he would sleep with the kids.
That's a big problem. You are torturing your wife. You are simply telling her that you are not good for me. You are not good for me. You must now go for other men. That's why you see unfairness, unfaithfulness enters the house. Because you are torturing your wife. You can't give her bread when she wants bread. Or you can't give her ogusi soup. Come here. Look at each other. Lift up your hands, say, Father. You are looking at me. Wait. After when you go home, this teaching will help you. Say, Father.
Father.
Help me.
Help me.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Look, sir. If you must go far in life,
yes.
Even this work that you are doing, they can fire you at any time. If, look, a woman, your wife, has the ability to open some certain doors. That's what people don't know. Your wife has the ability to open up doors for you. The moment you fight with your wife, wherever you are going, your doors are closed. Now, what you are going to do, sir, is to humble yourself. There must be a room where you can ask for forgiveness.
Yes.
Remember that you are going with her there. Eh?
Yes.
She did not say anything. Even now, she knows that this man was connected to that woman, but she still loves you.
Yes.
She still loves you. The day when you are in problem, that's when you will know who loves you.
Yes.
Let these other ladies continue playing. Wait. The day when you're in problem, that's when you will know who is going to stand for you. The woman that you are treating very bad, you will see. She'll be there by your bed. Nani, those shakara. She's a very good woman. She has made a lot of mistakes. A lot of mistakes.
Yes.
Even some of them you don't know. She has made a lot of mistakes.
Yes.
But there must be room for you to forgive her, and also for the sake of the children. You wouldn't allow your children to be raised up with another man or the stepdad.
No.
So now you must make up a decision to be a good husband and to be a good father to your children. To lead your house with God's principles.
Yes.
You must have a soft nature. He is your husband.
Yes.
Have a point of respect and submission. The problem with women is they can't submit themselves to authority. To submit is very easy. To be a good wife is very easy. Just understand your husband, what he loves and what he doesn't like. Like me in my house, you can't come. around 03. I will ask you where you're coming from. Because when I sleep, no one enters. That's my principle. That's how I raise my children. So my wife knows me that, okay, this is the way this man is. So you must know your husband, how he is, how, what makes him happy, what makes him to be hate. He can't just be hate just like that. There's something that caused him to do that.
Yes.
So now, you must leave that woman, eh?
Yes.
Leave him. Leave her. In fact, she's very ugly. Mary. Yes, I'm telling you. Mary. This woman, you know. This one. She will take you on top. I'm speaking this as a prophet. That woman. The day when you're in problem, there are women, they are just after money, the way you dress, they are emotional users. Emotional users. They are sex machines. They're just there to abuse you. And after they leave you. But this woman, she loves you genuinely. Leave that woman. If you love yourself, leave that woman. Leave her completely. Make this decision today to leave that woman. And you will see she'll be a best wife. I vow on the oil of ordination over my head. If your house will not be restored, come and ask me.
Yes.
God loves your house and God wants to bless you.
Yes.
You must forsake some certain women. Leave some certain women.
Yes.
You are a married man.
Yes.
Okay? Kneel down. You stand up. Give a microphone. It's first time. You know, there are women who cannot kneel down. There are men who cannot kneel down for their wives. I can tell you, me, when I was marrying my wife, I knelt down as a prophet. Kneeling down like this, I said, you know, I love you. This and that. I'll take you to Mauritius. Just want to say yes. She can tell my wife that I'm one of the humble guy. If I know I'm wrong right away, I'm so sorry. You will not die when you say sorry. You will not die. Yes, sir. Continue. She's your wife. You remember when you married her? She was not like this, eh?
Yeah.
You see the way you have done to her. So, speak, let's hear.
Clara, I would like you to forgive me for everything that happened before. I would like to start over and make things better in the way of God and growing up our children and make our life better. Yes. I love you and I will always do.
And on top of that, when you are asking forgiveness, you say, this thing, it will never repeat itself.
This thing will never repeat itself.
Now, what are you saying?
I think I have forgiven you.
Don't think.
Alrighty.
Speak.
I forgive you.
You have forgiven him?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yes.
Are you sure you not use what he did as a whip every time when you have a conflict?
No. I'll try my best not to.
You try your best, eh?
Yes.
There are women, when you fight, you'll be like, last time you did this. This day you did. They will bring the history of everything that you have ever done.
Stand up, sir. Kneel down. Kneel down. Ask him to forgive you.
Ricky, I want you to forgive me for everything I ever said to you. In any way I disrespected you, or in any way you felt as if I don't understand you or understand whatever you're going through, I want you to forgive me. I want us to raise our kids together. I love you.
Ricky, she loves you. I thought you must begin to jump when a woman tells you she loves you. You jump, you have won a trophy. Women, you'd think the women, they just say, I love you just like that. Never. Stand up, my daughter. Stand up. Now show her how much you love her. Yes. Put her two hands for Jesus. It's already done. Again. Do it again. I want to see. I got very well. Are you fighting or Ricky, you're a good man. You're a good man. You are a good daughter. Look, the Lord has a plan for this family.
Amen.
Okay.
Amen.
He has a big plan for this family. Come here. Kneel down here. Stretch forth your hands towards this couple. Father, in the name of Jesus, I bless this couple. I rebuke every spirit of divorce. I speak reconciliation. In the name of Jesus, I speak restoration. In the name of Jesus, this marriage will never be the same again. You will never divorce. You will never scatter. I rebuke the devil in your marriage. I speak success, breakthroughs, in Jesus' name. Amen. It is done. Rise up on your feet. Look, the Lord will bless you.
Thank you.
You are a very prosperous young man. If you can focus. Thank you, Jesus. The Lord will bless your house. And I want to stand as a father.
Amen.
I want to be there for you.
Amen.
Okay?
Amen.
May the Lord bless you. May the Lord lift you in Jesus' name. Put your two hands. Hold your wife. Hold Ricky, don't leave her now behind. Order. Put your two hands for Jesus. Lift up your hand and shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir. Where is your wife?
She's by home.
Eh?
She's with my home.
Yeah, you're supposed to come with her. So you will give you an appointment for next week. So you must come with her. Okay?
Okay.
You must come with her so that we solve your issue together. Okay?
Okay.
God bless you, sir. Put your two hands for Jesus. Rise up on our feet. Lift up your hands. Shh. Say, Father, in Jesus' name, touch my life. Change my life. Touch any place. Where they spend. In the name of Jesus. Lift up your hands. I want us to worship God. Lift up your hands. Just speak in tongues.
Shatika para hazedelos. Ikata para hazanas.
Then sings my soul.
Let's
Pastor Sipo Gwenya to come and bless us in this song as we're going to be worshiping God. Put our two hands as we're coming once again. Lift up your hands. Let's worship God. Speaking tongues. Come on. Then sings my soul, my Savior, go to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! Umukulu simaga ate. Then sings my soul, my Savior, God to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! Then sings my soul, my Savior, God to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! Then sings my soul. Oh, I literally cry.
Jehovah, how great,
my cousin Felix.
Who is this one by the name of David? Your grandfather. He's dead. How did he die?
He just came from the feud.
Huh?
And he died in the house.
He died in the house.
Yes.
There is a spirit from Zambia fighting you. Have you heard me?
Do something.
And that spirit, is a generational spirit. Can you just take your what? I want to write. I'll just write what the Lord is showing me. Finish. I'll just write. The Lord says, whatever generational curse that has been following your family members,
yes,
it is broken.
I received that.
That's the reason it has been very hard for you to settle.
Yes, even daddy. Here in South Africa, it has been very hard for you.
Yes, daddy. Eh? Yes, it is.
The Lord says that after 3 weeks from now,
I receive.
There will be a huge financial breakthrough.
I receive.
That he is going to give you.
I receive.
Take in Jesus' name. There's something to do with Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe. As I look at Zimbabwe, I see a business opportunity.
Go deep, Papa.
I see a business opportunity, but this business, it will be to do with transportation. The Lord is giving you a transportation company.
I receive, Papa.
Now, the Lord says, the greatest shall arush in the
asuka. I receive it.
Is this this side? This side.
Professor.
Wait. Your wife, is she here?
Yes, Papa, she's here.
Professor.
I'm looking for that woman. The greatest gift that the Lord has given you is your wife.
Thank you, Papa.
I see your debts be canceled. The Lord is canceling all your debts.
I receive, Papa.
Now, the problem that I see, what about this issue of the house? The house.
Papa, we are planning to buy a house, Papa.
Huh?
We are planning to buy a house,
okay,
Papa.
After 8 months,
I receive.
I be a prophet.
I receive, Papa.
I sign for you.
I receive, Papa.
Whatever was rejected,
I receive.
It shall be accepted.
I receive. Thank you, Jesus. Power.
You. There is a child.
Yes, Papa. True.
In Pretoria.
Yes, Papa. It's true.
You must take that child.
Yes, Papa.
Okay.
Yes, Papa.
But don't marry the mother.
Yes, Papa. Thank you, Papa. Thank you, Papa.
Don't marry the mother.
Thank you, Papa.
Take the child full responsibility.
Thank you, Papa. I'll do that. Power.
There is Shaligo Saliaba.
I receive.
You received like a job?
I'm still waiting.
You applied.
Yes. Eh? Yes, I did.
You applied.
Yes, I did.
Eh?
Yes.
You applied.
Yes, I did.
You applied. I see 3 weeks from now, they'll call you.
Thank okay? you. I receive.
They'll call you. They'll accept you.
I receive.
But I'm not seeing you in Joburg. It will be a job offer like Eastern Cape.
Northern Cape.
Power. Professor!
What do you know about Nigeria?
I was in Nigeria last week.
You were in Nigeria last week? Eh?
Yes.
Power!
You are a celebrity.
I receive.
Okay?
Yes.
The Lord is going to give you wisdom and knowledge.
Yes, I receive.
I see God's spirit. I see you as a breadwinner of your family.
I receive.
When I looked at you in the spirit, the Lord says, look at this young man. And when I looked at you, I was able to enter your life. Then I saw the second born in your family. When I looked at the second born, what number are you? What number are you?
95, no, number one.
First you born. Are number one.
Yes.
Who is the second born?
Ukatile.
Eh?
Ukatile.
You and Koatile. You are just two of you. Is it a boy or what?
A boy.
A boy. You are like very close.
Yeah.
Very close to each other.
Yes.
The Lord is going to lift you, both of you.
Yes, I can see.
You must stay away from alcohol and beer.
Yes, I can see.
Because it will contaminate the core of God. You are called by God.
Yes, I can see.
Okay? Take in Jesus' name. You, the Lord is going to use you mightily. He's going
I
to
receive.
Use the transportation business.
I receive.
Transportation business.
I receive.
But the Lord says, Shalika, do you know Sinyangwe?
Yes.
Who is Sinyangwe?
Mishek is my brother.
Eh?
Mishek
Sinyangwe.
Mishek Sinyangwe. Professor!
I pray for Mishek.
Oh, yes.
In Jesus' name.
I receive it
in Jesus
for him.
Name. Your wife, she's a very good woman.
I receive.
Your wife, she's a very good woman. Where is she? Eh? The
I
Lord
receive.
Is going to bless you. The Lord is going to bless
I
you.
Receive.
There is a financial increase coming your way.
I receive.
The Lord says every cord of financial delay, it is broken.
I receive.
A new season is coming on your way.
I receive.
The Lord is saying you will not be sick of diabetes.
I receive.
In Jesus' name.
I receive.
How are you? The Lord says I must cancel the spirit of diabetes over your household. Who is having diabetes? Huh?
My sister.
Your sister, she's having diabetes. After you leave this place, your sister should be healed from diabetes.
I receive.
In the name of Jesus.
Even arthritis, yes,
it is gone.
Yes.
But the Lord says, the issue, the problem of losing property, yes, it is over. There is a spirit that causes you to lose property. The Lord says it is canceled. There is a new dimension of miracles coming your way. Operation. What has happened with the operation?
I've done hysterectomy.
Eh?
Hysterectomy.
What is that?
Taking the womb
out. Taking out the womb. Operation.
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
Oh my God. Where is your husband?
He's at home.
He's at home. So you don't have a child?
I do have two.
You have two children. So your womb was taken out. I command a new womb to appear. In Jesus' name.
Thank
the Lord
Jesus.
Is going to bless you, but your mind is not. You are like wind. You are like wind. You don't have a base. You don't have a base. The Lord wants to bless you. The Lord wants to promote you.
Amen.
But the problem is your faith is too little. Your faith, it is too little. Increase your faith. And the time of settlement has come. You need to marry. The Lord has given you this year.
Find
a woman to marry, and the Lord is going to settle you. The Lord says there is a lot of money. There is a lot of money coming your way. This is a lot of money. Because when I was looking at you, I saw you speaking with presidents. There will be a president of Botswana. There will be a business to do with data services.
I receive.
The Lord says, pursue it, for it
I
is
receive.
Done.
I receive.
In the name of Jesus. The Lord says, we need to investigate your grandfather. Your grandfather. This is the spirit of poverty. The spirit of poverty. The spirit of poverty is so much in your lineage. The Lord says it will be broken. Even this spirit has made your children not to settle. All your children, they are not settled. The Lord says he's going to the source. He's going to the source.
Yes, Papa,
delivering you from the source.
There is
a breakthrough that is going to come to you, especially in the month of September. The month of September, there will be a lot of breakthroughs that will come for you. Take it in Jesus' name. My God, my God, my God. Come here. There is something here. There is something here. There is something here. Where are your children? Your children. Your children.
I don't have.
You don't have children?
No.
Oh. Have you ever been married?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Your problem is barrenness.
Yes.
Barrenness in your family. It's too much. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
There's a lot of barrenness. People, they get married, but to have children, it is a problem. In Jesus' name, be delivered. Can you leave the deliverance of this woman? Be free. It is done. Bring her. Bring her here. Bring her here. I'll prophesy to those that are ready. Those that are spiritual. Where do you work?
Pharmacy.
Huh?
Pharmacy, Papa.
Be careful. Be vigilant. Okay?
Okay,
be vigilant.
Papa.
Days are evil.
Okay? Papa.
Right, there's
Papa.
A lot of sabotage. There's a lot of people who are jealous of you.
All right, Papa.
Okay?
Okay,
they are jealous of you.
Okay,
I cover you in the blood of Jesus.
I declare promotion.
A seal of promotion. In the name of Jesus. Those who are not ready, I don't know what you're waiting for. If I was you, I would have said, prophet, I need it. It's me now.
It's me now.
What is that?
Engineer. Yes.
What do you do?
An engineer by profession, but I changed
to teaching.
Yes, to teaching right now.
Power!
Go back to engineering.
I receive it, my Lord.
There is a demon that gave you evil thoughts to leave engineering.
I receive it.
And to go for teaching.
I receive it.
Go back to engineering. The Lord, I see a big warehouse where you'll be like working on cars.
I receive it.
You are free in Jesus' name.
I receive it, man of God.
You are free in Jesus' name. Your business, the Lord says your business is going to turn around three times. Turn around three times. I'm giving instruction right now. If I was you, I'd have celebrated.
Thank you, Jesus.
Today is just instruction. Where is your husband? If me, I was you, I would have begun to say, man of God, it's me. It's my time.
Man of God, I don't have it. He deserted me. That is the one who deserted
me. He left
me with
you.
No reason. Yes.
Eh?
Yes, man of God.
He left
with
you.
No reason. Yes.
Also, leave
I
him.
Want him back.
Oh. No, leave him.
Oh, thank you, man of God.
Leave him.
Okay, I will do that.
There
man of
is
God.
Another thank man coming.
Oh, I receive him.
There is another man coming. The Lord says the spirit of divorce is broken.
Oh, I receive.
There was a spirit that allows people to enter marriage, and when they enter marriage, they don't stay in marriage.
Oh, yes,
the Lord says that spirit is broken.
Oh,
by July 28, another man will appear. Take Jesus' name. The Lord says, your house,
yes, Papa,
your house,
yes, Papa,
your house,
yes, Papa,
there will never be a homosexual.
Yes, Papa.
There will never be a homosexual.
Yes, Papa.
Says the Spirit of the Lord.
I receive
that,
Papa.
That spirit that tries to enter your brother, the Lord says it is canceled.
I receive.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive.
Your brother,
Papa,
is delivered right
I
now.
I receive, Papa.
The Lord says.
Yes,
the Lord
Papa.
Says. The Shadabahata.
I receive it.
The Lord says this promotion.
I receive,
coming
Papa.
For you.
I receive.
Be faithful.
I receive.
And it shall exhort you.
I receive.
You are free from diabetes. You are free. You are free from HIV.
I
you are free. Where do you work? Where do you work?
SPV.
Eh?
SPV.
What is this place?
Bedford.
Eh?
It's a security company.
Let me tell you something. Woman, by this time, you're supposed to be far. But the problem with you is that you eat what belongs to the Lord. You eat what belongs to the Lord. What I mean is tithe. You eat tithe. You eat tithe. That's the reason you're in problem financially.
Yes.
Is it true?
Yes, it's true.
You eat a lot of tithe. That's the reason you're in problem. Things are not working for you.
Exactly.
The Lord says, be faithful in the area of tithe. He will exhort you. He will lift you. And I've seen also settlement in the area of marriage. Where is your child? Where is your child?
He's in Pretoria.
He's in Pretoria. Where is the father?
Father is in Cosmo City.
He's in Cosmo City.
Yes.
There is a restoration between you and the father.
I receive.
Go. It is done. Who is this man here? Who is this man?
Carlton.
Carlton, you are healed. It is well. It is well. The Lord has heard your prayer. The Lord has heard your prayer. Anyone that I will sign for.
I receive.
Anyone that I will sign for.
I receive it.
You shall testify.
I receive it.
You shall testify.
I receive it.
You shall have trucks. You shall have houses. You shall have companies. In Jesus' name, it is done. The Lord says you must enter into a boutique business.
I receive.
A boutique business.
I receive.
A boutique business.
I receive.
Who is this one? Like Chanda, Chanda. Chanda. Your sister-in-law.
Yes.
Be very careful. Be very careful. The devil is about. He's looking for your household. For your household. For your household. Let your husband be close to you. There is a spirit that is claiming you for you to go back to Zambia. For you to go back to Zambia. The Lord says it is cancelled. Settle here in South Africa. The Lord will give you houses. The Lord will give you businesses. The Lord will give you saloons. The Lord will give you houses. The Lord will give you money. You shall be a kingdom financier. Take in the name of Jesus. The Lord says you are healed from BP. You are healed from BP. And the stroke wanted to kill you. But the Spirit of the Lord says stroke will never be the routine of your life. Whatever you saw yesterday, you shall look for it today. You will never see it anymore. It is done. The Lord is saying, Koshaliaba, your daughter, there is a restoration in marriage. Restoration in marriage. The Lord is saying, the spirit that destroyed your house, the Lord is saying, it will never destroy your children. In the name of Jesus, the generational curse is broken. There is a new season coming your way. Take.
I receive it.
I receive it.
I receive it. I receive it.
I
receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Lord, anyone I sign for.
I receive it.
Anyone I sign for.
I receive it.
Those that believe that I am a prophet.
I receive it.
Cause their lives to change.
I receive it.
Take.
I receive it.
Take.
It
in Jesus'
name. I receive it. Power.
Do you smoke, sir? The Lord says, run away from the spirit of smoke. You must pray a lot. Who is in breads?
It's my friend.
Who is in breads?
My friend.
Can you speak up, sir?
It's my friend.
He's your friend.
Yes.
There's a business opportunity that the Lord is giving you. This business opportunity is in the area of transportation business. Transportation business. I see you buying like buses. The Lord will help you. The Lord will help you.
I receive it.
I pray for you.
I receive it.
Are you pregnant? Eh?
Yes.
You are pregnant. Eh? You are pregnant.
Yes.
On top of it, you have diabetes.
Yes.
Diabetes is healed.
Amen.
You are healed.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. Is it true? Is it true?
Yes.
You have diabetes. It's healed. It's healed.
I receive it.
It is healed. It is healed.
I receive it.
It is healed. It is healed. It is healed. By the power of the Holy Ghost.
I receive it.
By the power of the Holy Ghost.
I receive it. Power. Professor.
Let me just stop.
Ah. Professor.
The house you are building,
Amen.
The Lord says,
Amen.
It will finish.
He
will finish it.
Jesus.
You will not die before your time. Accident will not claim you.
The
Bible says the hands of Zerubbabel, they have laid the foundation of the temple, and the same hands shall finish
it.
The Lord says what you have started, you will finish that house.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you,
Jesus. The Lord says, come here. Are you a Nigerian or what?
No, I'm Zimbabwean.
You are Zimbabwean?
Yes, Papa.
Huh?
Yes, Papa.
What do you know? The Lord is saying the farm. Go and buy a farm.
I receive, Papa.
There is grace for you in the area of crops.
I receive, Papa.
Be very careful also. Be very careful with people. There's a lot of evil people around you. Be very careful and be vigilant. You are covered in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let me speak to a lot of people. Today I did not come. I came to sign. The moment I sign for you,
I receive it.
Just begin to celebrate.
I receive it. Pow!
Baby. I came to sign. Some of you, poverty has been following you. Just stand where you are. Just stand. I'll come. Lift up your hands. Say, Father.
Father.
In Jesus' name. Surprise me. By the power of the Holy Ghost.
In Jesus' name.
Diabetes. You need healing now.
Prophesy, men of God. Prophesy.
Touch my hand. Where is your child? 1, 2. They have accepted you for employment. You.
They
have accepted you for employment.
I receive.
You applied.
Yes.
You have been accepted.
Oh, I receive. Thank you, Jesus.
Write my prophecy. Yeah. Write my prophecy. Write my prophecy.
What are you saying?
last week you prayed for me.
Yes.
My mother was sick. I tell you, my mother is sick. Then you said, let me solve this problem first. Then you said, she's healed. That same time, she jumped and she was healed until now.
Pow!
Yes, my husband.
There is a big project.
Amen, Papa.
That your husband is going to win.
Amen. I receive it.
It is done.
I receive it.
It does not make sense. But this is the power of God.
Yes!
It's the power of God.
Yes.
Don't reject your husband. Don't reject your husband. Maso shadiga. Mano so shadigu. Imaso shadig. La Rocha de Go,
I receive.
Sasa de Go,
I receive.
Power,
I receive.
Masha de Go,
I receive.
Limo Shadi,
I receive it.
Ima Soshede Gosadi,
I receive.
Marika Tusalia Rush,
I receive it.
Melerene Zubiato,
I receive it.
Merush Idiasuka,
I receive it.
Sezizo Zoziga,
I receive it. I receive it.
The Spirit of the Lord says,
I receive it.
As He's signing for you,
I receive it.
Whatever was rejected,
I receive it.
Any rejected document,
I receive it.
It is receiving acceptance.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus,
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus,
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus,
I receive it.
By the Spirit of God,
I receive it.
By the unction of God,
I receive it.
Over my life,
I receive it.
As signed for you,
I receive it.
This week,
I receive it.
It is a week of deliverance.
I receive it.
Financial grace.
I receive it.
Financial deliverance.
I receive it.
Financial deliverance.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Even the money.
I receive it.
That you lost.
I receive it.
There is a restoration.
I receive it.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
I receive it.
By the power of God.
I receive it.
By the authority of God.
I receive it.
I decree and declare.
I receive it.
Houses are coming.
I receive it.
Cars are coming.
I receive it.
Your mother is healed.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Your debts are canceled.
I receive it.
Your house is accepted.
I receive it.
It is released.
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 I receive it.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Your permanent residence is released.
I receive it.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
I receive it.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Your son is coming back.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Your documents, they are accepted.
I receive it.
Your tenders are released.
I receive it.
Your company will receive good news.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
21 people hearing the Son of God.
I receive it.
Starting from today,
I receive it.
You will not suffer financially.
I receive it.
I receive it. In Jesus' name,
I receive it.
I declare.
I receive
over
it.
Over your life.
I receive
your
it.
Your finances.
I receive
your
it.
Your house.
I receive
as
it.
As your hands are lifted.
I receive
your
it.
Your documents are lifted.
I receive it.
There is a turnaround.
I receive it.
Taking place.
I receive it.
Financially.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Where you were rejected.
I receive it.
You shall be accepted.
I receive it.
In Jesus' name.
I receive it.
In Jesus' name.
I receive it.
In Jesus' name.
I receive it.
Every married woman.
I receive it.
Every single woman.
I receive it.
Every divorced woman.
I receive it.
There is a restoration. There is a restoration. Every man. There is a financial restoration.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Lift up your hands. Say, I receive. I receive.
I receive. I receive. I receive. I receive. I receive. I receive it. I receive it. I receive it.
Lift up your documents. The Lord spoke to me. When prophets are declaring, I know how God uses me. I know. Whenever God is about to do something. Come here. Come here. Come here. What do you want God to do for you?
Nothing. I've got four cars, but none of them. Everything is down.
Everything is down.
Yes, sir.
Bring a paper.
I receive it.
La no show.
I receive it.
Lena no shada.
I receive it.
Sa so
I receive it.
Mela no shadi.
I receive it.
Shadiga.
I receive it.
Lima so shadi.
I receive it.
Le ronge de shadosa. The Spirit of God is bringing a financial restoration.
I receive it. I receive it.
Lord,
I receive it.
Because of thy servant.
I receive it.
Not because of their faith.
I receive it.
Because of thy servant.
I receive it.
Honor my words.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
The Lord will bless you.
Amen. I receive.
Shano kofernika subalalia.
I receive it.
Paradisco fradisco.
I receive it.
Shako shale
paradisco. I receive it.
My wife, come here. Come here. Take the microphone.
Pow.
My wife, come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. I hear something here. Kasubrakia.
I receive it.
Where's my wife? Where's the microphone? Where's the microphone? Where's the microphone? Give her the microphone. Malesho
Bihar. I receive it.
Lanush idia paranosko vehe.
I hear the voice of the Lord.
Larish kuvenesha valenosko vehe.
That your life has been so much in. You've gone through so much in your life.
Pleniski liharush idia suka.
But this problem is starting from where you're coming from.
Meloroshi idia suku palenesho ve.
And the Lord is going to do something great that will bring a blessing even into your family.
Lariku shatiku salia kutu palenesho.
And you cannot understand what the prophet is saying right now.
Lariku shedia kuse melene obera idia kusha
leneza. But the Lord is going to shock you and He'll bless you.
Masuku, masuku, masuku.
And your blessings will be multiple and multiple and
masuku,
multiple.
Masuku, masuku, masuku.
And it will be greater and greater. Your life is turning around and around and around and around. And everything
about
you
is turning
around.
The same way everybody else is turning around.
Le supranezo
vene. Your lives are turning around. Your lives are turning around.
Sheno, 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 sheno. Sheno, sheno, sheno. Sheno, sheno, sheno. Sheno, sheno. La Jesu Christo.
My daughter,
Shanae,
who is Shanae?
Shanae.
You're Shanae?
Shanae. Shomeno the Nasia Lia Hoso.
The Lord is showing me something about your name.
La Peronisuya Balanisha Lebranishale Sheliaka.
But this is something to do with finances.
Masia Koshe.
What do you know about this thing to do with finance or something to do with
finance?
This is something to do with finances.
I work with finance.
You work with finance.
Pow!
Shemendo, shemendo pelenisko veleja, la rush inia masho.
He has one. You have. There's a one child that he's looking in the spirit.
La rush inia bara nushko ba makusha de pa suka.
And the mother is seeing, from your mother is seeing two children.
Yes.
We are the two of you.
Power!
Perush idi suka balia lushalia suka ven evelinisho felenia. La suk alia subaraniso behe.
But there's also a problem to do with your stomach because he has to pray for you against an operation.
Yes. I had a leprosectomy.
You so had a one? You had an operation?
Yes, I had.
We praise the Lord.
I had three operations.
Lovre shudia pranisco la shadia so shudia bene.
Okay, so he's also going to see two children about your life as well.
Two
children
daughters.
About your children.
I have two daughters.
Two girls about your children.
Pow!
Koshania, suka, suka prane.
Okay, so the prophet is saying, he's also seeing two children in your life. He's seeing two children about your family from your mother. He saw two children.
Yeah.
And he's also seeing two children in your family. Some with girls, and he also saw like something to do with an operation. So he's saying we must pray against this operation.
Yes. Thank you.
My daughter, God is going to do something new in your life. But this is something to do with a movement like flying from one country to the other.
I receive.
Because he's seeing you moving from three different places.
I receive.
But this is a place where there'll be... Jesus, help me. It's like he's seeing you in a place where there'll be a lot of great, 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 great men. You're sitting in front of great men.
I receive.
Mama Suvia.
Where is your mother?
She's in Cape Town.
She's in Cape Town. Okay, thank you.
Because
he has to pray for your mother because there's something to do with your mother's health. With something to do with her heart and her BP, something like that.
Yes, she's got diabetes.
She has diabetes. To pray for the mother because the mother needs...
Professor!
The mother is good in the name of Jesus
Christ.
Lift up your hands.
Thank you, Lord.
Come,
my dear.
Makosh.
Your hands.
Lakush.
Your hands are going to touch so many blessings because
I receive.
Your hands are blessed hands.
I receive.
Zosia si paros ya ku paradigos.
Your heart needs to release certain things of your past.
I receive.
You know you have gone through so much, but you need to let go and give your mother everything around you. Because seeing three people, he's seeing you surrounded with three.
I'm a third born.
You are the third born in the family. But the Lord is going to lift you up and he's going to lift you among
Jesus Christ.
In Jesus' name, thank you, Lord.
I receive it. I receive it. I receive it.
May you receive your miracle.
I receive it.
Claim your word in the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Receive it in the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
You are blessed in Jesus.
I receive it.
You are blessed in Jesus.
I receive it.
The Lord is saying, a lot of people here, they have already received their testimonies.
I receive it!
Pesa.
There is one person in this place.
Pesa.
There is one person in this house.
Pesa pelenescu vie haliare shobahanebe.
Seeing this person going, it's like your destiny and your way has already been opened up.
I receive it!
Your destiny has already been opened
up. I receive it!
A lot of people here, your miracles have already been received, they have already been released, but it's like you are not showing your excitement that you have already received.
I receive it. Power.
There is something to do with you in green over there. He's seeing something to do with where he is coming from.
Yes, I'm from Zambia.
You are also from Zambia.
Power!
Now, your problem is also starting from where you're coming from in Zambia. There is something in common with somebody here. You. Which one? This one.
Benosh.
There is something in common with you.
Benosh.
The child, your child, or something to do with your child.
No.
With a name.
My child is Tyrone, then the other one is Mapalo.
Huh?
Mapalo.
And the other name?
Tyrone Musonda.
Musonda Tyrone. What's your name? Mutale.
Mutale.
But there is some kind of connection to do with his name, your name somewhere.
My young sister.
Huh?
Musonda is my young sister.
Your Musonda is your young sister, and Musonda is.
Power!
Praise the Lord. What God is alive?
Amen.
Where is your husband?
He's at home.
Because there is a lot of drinking and a lot of confusion in your marriage.
Yes, it's true. He drinks a lot. And we normally argue.
There is a lot of confusion, a lot of fighting going on. But you need to forgive.
Messiah.
You need to forgive.
I'll do so.
You need to forgive.
I'll do so.
Jesus Christ.
Name of Jesus.
Be
blessed. Lift up your hands.
I receive.
Rikusha tu sasiata.
You are blessed in Jesus'
name. I receive.
Jenone eluria suka palaloshe.
Today you are blessed in Jesus' name.
I receive it.
Those are being opened in the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Lucia, Irushadia,
gates are being opened in the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
Your international business is being opened. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Merusha, Merusha, Merusha. Merusha, Merusha. Merusha, Merusha. Merusha, Merusha. Merusha, Merusha. Merusha, Merusha. Merusha, Merusha.
Merusha, Merusha. Merusha,
Merusha.
I receive it. In 4 days from today,
I receive it.
On each and every day, 4 days from today, there will be strange things that will be happening around
you. I receive it.
You have received.
I receive it.
Lift up your hands and just thank God. Thank you, Jesus.
Lift up your hands. Father, thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for speaking to us.
Amen.
Thank you for speaking to us.
Amen.
Lift up your hands. Say, Father.
Father.
My life.
My life.
We will never be the same again.
We never be the same again.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
The Lord says, this week, it is a week of grace.
I receive it.
It's a week of grace.
I receive it.
The moment I leave the altar, Shali Baradia.
I receive.
Take your seat. Connect yourself to the declaration.
Amen.
As your hands are lifted,
I receive it.
Korishia
su. I receive it. I receive it. I receive it.
Lord, I decree this week.
I receive it.
To be a week of deliverance.
I receive it.
All those that are watching me right now.
I receive it.
I decree to you.
I receive it.
This week to be a week of grace.
I receive it.
And financial deliverance.
I receive it.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it.
I receive it. May the Lord bless you. I guess you have received. I receive it. I guess you are connecting yourself to the grace of God. Your life has turned around. I receive it. This week your debts are canceled.
I receive it.
There is a financial increase.
I receive it.
Financial multiplication.
I receive it.
I see money.
I receive it.
Debt cancellation.
I receive it.
Houses being released.
I receive it.
Court cases are being broken.
I receive it.
In the name
name of Jesus.
I receive
miracle
it.
Babies.
I receive
miracle
it.
Promotion.
I receive it.
I see your boss calling you.
I receive
wherever
it.
You apply,
I receive
you have been accepted.
I receive
promotion
I receive
in your
it.
Ministry,
I receive
at your
it.
Workplace,
I receive
in your church.
I receive
in the name of Jesus,
I
you are healed.
It.
I can see you.
I receive
you
it.
Are healed. Cancer is healed. Arthritis is healed. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. This week is a week of grace and financial deliverance. Rush right now. Connect yourself. May the Lord bless you. Shalom. 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 God bless you. Thank you.